tell us in the comment. Don't forget to hit the like button and share this video with everyone you know.
So every week, pinag-uusapan natin dito sa show ang iba't ibang mga paraan para lalo pang lumakas ang ating overall confidence. And this time, I want on this type of confidence, no, na napaka-importante for us to nourish. Especially ngayon na may mga online platforms that are booming. Countless issues are piling up and with many of us just feeling cooped up at home. This is called creative confidence. And everyone has the potential to grow it. So you know, creativity takes on many forms talaga. So just because hindi ka artist, hindi ka illustrator or designer, it doesn't mean hindi ka isang creative person. Even admin work can be creative. It's just a matter of building the confidence to put your work out there and making it relevant. So luckily for us, social media has made it really so much easier for many to exercise this creativity. Dito pumasok ang content creating and turn into a hobby or job altogether for a lot of people. Which is why today, I've invited two amazing digital content creators who have just maximized content creating online so well by voicing out their opinions and advocacies, telling stories, as well as simply sharing personal quirks and pieces of themselves. So stay tuned for a creativity boosting afternoon ahead. Alright, ito na. It's time to invite in our special guests for this afternoon. Let me welcome our first guest. Graduated with an MA in Arts and Lifestyle Journalism at the University of the Arts, London. Journalist, written for the Philippine Daily Inquirer, Vice Asia, and whenandmanila.com to name a few. A digital content creator and a social media specialist, we have Ysabel Vitangcol.
Hi, good afternoon. Thanks for having me.
Hi, Ysabel. Happy Saturday to you.
Hello, kamusta?
Welcome to Beauty in a Box. Napakasaya natin today kasi I'm so excited for our topic, no? Very exciting ang ating mga pag-usapan. So, before we proceed, let's complete our group. So, we also have a mental health advocate, the founder and managing director of Spring Philippines, acknowledged as one of Lifestyle Asia's Women of the Day and Lifestyle Asia's Game Changer in 2019, and also a digital content creator. We have Bettina Jose.
Hi everyone. Good afternoon. Hi. Thanks for having me.
Hi Bettina. Welcome to viewers could get to know you both a little bit more, no, before we proceed to other things. Can you tell us a little bit about your work and what you do? So this can be like you can be like your content creation and like your content that you guys usually put out. So this from your social media accounts or like or what you release from your jobs. So, we can start again now naman kay Bettina.
Sige. Well, like I said kanina, no, Aliyah, my attack, per se, or the way I use my social media is really just to get to know people better and for people to get to know me better. So, it will take a quick scan of my Instagram to know hindi ako nakocurate. Like, hindi ako magaling dyan. I mean, when it comes to content creation, I put out what I feel really represents me. So that's always been me. I mean, for as long as I've been on social media, for as long as the platform has been around, that's always sort of what I've been doing with it. You know, I was telling you guys earlier, but for everyone else who's watching, I'm a host and I'm a public speaker. And, you know, I'm very used to interacting with people, but actually I'm very introverted as a person. So mahirap sa akin mag-foster ng connections in real life. Kasi nauunahan ako ng introvertedness ko. So social media for me has become some kind of a safe haven to connect with people without that pressure of, you know, the person, like the in-person interaction. So for me, when I put out content, my only rule is that it represents me. Like, I have this rule of thumb where I'm not gonna put anything out if my friends and family can't hear my voice saying it. So if I caption something, if I write something, if I post in a certain place, it has no place in my social media if the people around me, or the people who know me really well, feel like, ah, si Bettina ba to? So that's my only rule when I create content. It's like, if I feel like I look good there and it makes me feel good, I'll post that. If it doesn't fit the feed, I don't really care that much about it. For as long as I feel like nagka-translate kung sino ako as a person.
Nice to hear it kasi shape, yun ang variety ngayon ng mga content creators. Kasi may mga content creators who really have to follow a certain parang type of like, yung mga sasabi nga, like feed, or like true, certain type of content you put out there, no? So ito yung maganda natin na makikita kasi you can be a content creator without being very strict with what you post. Just be yourself, Ysabel. What content type of content do you usually put out? So yung social media mo and your readings from your jobs.
Okay, so siguro I'll start with my own, with my personal own social media. I'd have to agree with Bettina na talagang it's really good to put yourself out there if you're very authentic. Because most people think nowadays, like content creators or influencers would be na, and napaka superficial kasi this is just a sponsored photo, a sponsored video, ganon. But nowadays, especially nowadays, I try my best to be as authentic as possible. Even if I, admittedly, I like to follow like a certain feed, I still try to make sure na ako pa rin to. And with my social media, I like doing personal stories, I like doing travel, and I like doing lifestyle. And as of late, I'm starting to dab on social issues na rin, just to be in sync with what's happening right now, you know, with the pandemic and all. And for my line of work naman, ganun rin. Sometimes I dab on fashion, sometimes I dab on art, occasionally travel, but my main genre for writing or for creating content for the newspapers or for the digital platforms that I work for is lifestyle, definitely.
How do you voice out and shed light on certain issues?
Well, you know, I'm gonna make my advocacy last, but I guess that's touched on what you said, which was social issues and, you know, everything that's been happening nowadays. I've never been one to shy away from speaking my mind and making my opinions, whether or not it's popular or not. So I know at this time, and especially with our current, you know,
how do I situation.
It's very hard. I understand the fear that people feel in speaking out and making their voices heard, especially with regard to our government and, you know, the way the people, the Filipino people have been suffering because of this pandemic. It's not a very pretty thing to talk about, you know, but
yes,
for me, kasi, like I said kanina, ever since nailang ako to call myself an influencer, I don't really like calling myself that. I don't really, I've never really found myself worthy, per se, of being called an influencer. But I have embraced the fact that I know I have influence over a certain group and a certain circle. And because I know that and I acknowledge and I embrace that, I knew that I had the responsibility to speak up on things and, you know, speak up about matters that are were important. So I knew that if I had influence or if I had the slightest chance of, you know, influencing people, I was going to use that voice for things that mattered, for ideas that needed to be talked about, concepts that needed to be shed light on. So I knew that I've always wanted to use my platform to shed light on things that were important to me and the world at large. So ako hindi ako natatakot to say, to call a spade and say, you're not handling it right, this is unjust. And for me, malaking bagay to hear kasi influencers speak up about social issues.
Yes.
Because
yes,
hindi siya accept, parang hindi siya pretty eh. You know how like content creators are expected to churn out really pretty, beautiful content. But it's, you know, when you're an influencer, natatakot ka with how certain opinions will be received. But me, if I feel like it needs to be put out there, hindi ako matatakot to put it out there. So I have on numerous occasions used my Instagram or even my organization, which is Spring. I've tried to use those platforms to churn out really important messages about injustice. You know, whether it's the BLM movement or the anti-terror bill, or just really how we've handled this entire situation in this pandemic. I have tried to put it out there, but alam ko din na mabigat i-consume tong information ito. Parang mabigat na nga yung pinagdadaanan ng mga tao eh. So you don't want to be so aggressive and so, you know, serious in tone. So the way I've always done it is to inject my tone in it. Ako kasi bilang yung personality ko, bilang like influencer, I'm very kalog. Obvious naman siguro in the way I'm talking now, or those who know, palaloko talaga ako, I'm very kalog. But I will talk to you about things that matter. So that's how I've been trying to put things out and messages out. Syempre, mag-i-inject ako ng humor here and there. Pero you can be sure na pag-uusapan ko yung mga bagay na feeling ko need to be talked about. So that's the way I've been trying to do it, is bringing forth these topics and these issues in a way that's easily digestible to people and in a way that's relatable. Because more than anything at this point, feeling ko kailangan natin mag-relate to one another.
Ganda na sinabi mo, Bettina. Yung, I just want to highlight what you said nga. The way you put out the whatever you put, voice out, yung mga opinions mo, has to be, you have to inject yung pagka-friend, yung the way you are pa rin. Ikaw, Ysabel, how have you used like your platforms, your to voice out and shed light?
Okay, so I've been writing for a while now. So I write anything my mind speaks of, or whether it's personal or whatnot. But when I got into the line of work of journalism, I started writing for different platforms, medyo mas naging fixed ang mga sinusulat ko. And once I started transitioning more to my own platform, like I focused more on my own content, that's when I started speaking my mind out some more. Other than siguro yung mga nararamdaman ko and all, I also try to be as relatable as possible to who I reach out to, whether it's people who watch my blog, people who read my Instagram posts or my blog. I want to be that platform or that influencer, as what Bettina would say, to encourage or share these kinds of ideas that I have. You don't have to necessarily agree with me. We can, you know, have an open discussion about it. But for me, I feel like I have this sort of responsibility of sharing what I know to others. I mean, like say, since we're talking about social issues here, I may not be an expert in politics or economics or whatnot, but as my right as a Filipino citizen, I want to share what I know and what I feel could be the betterment of our country. Like, lalo na ngayon, it's a very trying time for everyone, you know, and you just want to be the best version of yourself and as a citizen. So what I do with my platforms is that since nowadays there's a lot going on, I try to make it as relatable to the people as possible, since this is how the viewers or the fans or those who follow you are more drawn to really want to be in that spot to be canceled. Pero I just want to be myself. I just want to explain what I know and what I feel. And I think that's the essence of being an influencer, kasi it's trying to encourage and share your ideas, whether or not people agree with you or they don't. And lalo na ngayon, I think it really brought out the influencer side of me, kasi I'm just used to writing about this, writing about that, but I'm not exactly used to writing about deeper issues. Like what Bettina said, some issues are very uncomfortable to discuss, and that's what makes it worth discussing, kasi these are certain things that should be talked about. Para hindi lang para sa kalagayan eh, pero para sa kalagayan ng lahat. So, it's been a topsy-turvy journey for me, I think. Lalo na ngayon, itong quarantine that we can't really go outside and our activities are limited. But I think it has also brought out the creative side of me in trying to creatively discuss these things that actually matter.
Yan.
Stay tuned for the next episode.
Only here on Z81 Radio, Manila.